Hey everybody, happy Saturday. Today, I want to start by saying the world continues to go downhill. Everything is racism and sexism. If your default setting automatically is racism and sexism, perhaps you have the problem. That's it. Maybe you have the problem. I don't know if you guys are hockey fans, but I am. And Mike Milbury made a comment last week about these players in the bubble, just players, all men. He said, good thing the women aren't here to distract them. And he was labeled a sexist. I'm going to tell you, he's a realist. Because you women are distracting. Our brains are wired differently on a different set of synapses than yours. We see women, we get distracted. It's just, again, like the mask and the teenagers, hormones. That's all it is. The man isn't a sexist. He's not a sexist. You keep talking about race. I am very lucky to have a diverse group of friends. White, black, Hispanic, Asian, gay. It doesn't make a difference. The people are good people or bad people. And I consider myself very lucky that they're my friends, because most people wouldn't put up with me. And I love them. The Puerto Ricans especially. I have one. She's fantastic. I can't understand a word out of her mouth half the time. But you know what? You don't know love until a Puerto Rican woman with a smile on her face tells you, F you. And I got another one. The Puerto Rican bear still can't figure out why he swam from Puerto Rico to the States for freedom. We're still trying to comprehend that. We're still hoping they build a wall around his house so he can't get out. Maybe he'll save cost on the ankle bracelet. I don't know. But once again, he's like a brother to me, and I am lucky that he feels the same. I would trust him with my life and my kids. The one race I have a problem with is the long-haired, goofy musician race. Because I am positive he's a good friend, but he marks other in that race every single time. So come on, get yourselves together, and let's start enjoying the people. Good people, bad people, and stupid people. Speaking about stupid people. A man was detained because he was overheard saying he was going to blow up the bathroom. Yep. I don't even know what to say with that. But he was detained. Somebody detained him for making that comment. More stupid news coming from our government, which doesn't surprise anybody. New York State Education said that they are taking driver's ed for 60-year-olds and making it completely remote. They don't need to drive. Yep, don't need to drive. Something about that doesn't feel safe. This is not Gran Torino. It's a real car. Unbelievable. More stupid. The new term people are looking for, because everybody's getting mortally offended, is to become micro-offended. So the term is called microaggression. Microaggression. It's when you feel subtly offended by an off-color joke that may offend you sexually or by race or by your intelligence. Isn't that a joke? I don't know. Here at home, things are going well, still. But I'll tell you, weeks ago, I said my dog never stops barking. My wife never stops talking. She never stops. She's got to talk to me about everything. I don't know why. As I said, I'm not that important. What do you need to tell me? The interesting thing is, she says she has great hearing, but she never hears a word I say. In, out. Blah, 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 blah. Come on. She goes out the other day, and I'm with the squirrels. One squirrel's watching TV, the other squirrel's coloring. It's nice and quiet. She comes home, pandemonium breaks out. There's yelling, there's screaming, you're too close to the TV, why are the crayons on the floor, kids are yelling, screaming, I don't understand. So I said, hey, come on, man. I said, at the risk of being celibate, did you ever think it was you? She didn't say much after that, so I'm not sure, but I'll let you know how the celibacy thing goes out as these weeks progress. I don't know. The reason why I haven't gone shining is alcohol. I have a choice. Murder or alcohol. The only thing I seem to be murdering is my liver. I figured to myself, I'm drinking a little too much, so cut down on coffee. I am very concerned when the bars start opening up again, because my tolerance is so high, it's going to cost me two bills a night just to go out and get a buzz. I told you, got to wean off. Got to start it soon. This is too much. So I have an idea how to clear a room. I was out the other day at the liquor store. I wanted to see if they had that water lithium, see if it was available yet from Britain. Didn't have it, by the way. So I get out of my car and I sneeze. People looked at me like I had leprosy. I sneezed. I see the sun sometimes. I sneeze. I didn't have my mask on yet. I just got out of the car. You can clear out any room with a sneeze. Anything. Anything. So I'll finish with something Donald Trump said at the RNC. He said he is dedicated to getting a woman on the moon. Does anybody think that woman is Hillary Rodham Clinton? I certainly do. So now remember, everybody, change starts with you. Go out, hug somebody, give them a kiss, tell them you love them. And I want to tell all my friends who are watching this, God bless you. I love you. I love you if you're watching this. Go Islanders, by the way. Game later on tonight. I love you all. Cheers.